Alright, so sorry for the lighting here sucking, everybody. We're at the convention center now. We just went through the registration process. I think most people are probably in their hotel rooms or something right now. So there's not a whole lot of people, as you can see. However, in certain areas, like down there, you can see a few people. See, there's somebody there dressed in black and white. It is Deadpool wearing a panda hoodie. So, yeah. It's different, but it's still Deadpool. So, of course, my son, he freaking loved it. He loves Deadpool. So, now we're just kind of wandering around aimlessly waiting for our roommates to show up. So, yeah. Alright, so the first person is a Sub-Zero cosplayer. So what brings you to Kumoricon?
I've actually been going to Kumoricon since 2007 actually, otherwise known as the infamous Year of Epic Fail.
Which, it really did suck that year. It really did. So, obviously Sub-Zero, not necessarily a traditional anime character. How many non-anime characters do you see here?
I've actually seen several non-anime characters. I've actually seen a Darren and Genie from I Dream of Genie. I got a friend who's actually dressed as Deadpool.
There we go.
I've actually seen a Spider-Man and a Black Cat. Hello, Kitty!
So, even though this is an anime convention, would you say that we're very welcoming to other fandoms?
Absolutely. I've actually seen people dressed up as Doctor Who number 4, Tom Baker, who were absolutely welcome in.
Alright, there we go. So for the people who haven't gone to a convention before, maybe that are a little skeptical on it, what would you say to them to encourage them to possibly come to a convention?
My advice to them is don't be afraid, just go. And whatever you do, don't put in any expectation except having a good time.
Okay. Now, your costume, some people make their own, some people get them crafted by like a shop or something like that. Where did you get your costume at?
My friend, Micah Metz, he actually has a friend who does costume work.
Okay. That it?
That's all.
Alrighty. So, let's say that somebody's trying to work on a costume, and it looks like shit. Should they still go wearing that costume, do you think?
Yes.
Okay, and why do you say that?
Because it's all about love of the craft.
Love of the craft. Do you hear that? It's all about the love, baby. All about the love.
Yes.
Alright, well thank you very much, and be sure to kick Scorpion in the head for me, will you? Yeah! Next up, we've got the Elric brothers from Full Metal Alchemist.
Hey!
Here, actually, let me turn around this way. YouTube trick! Alright, so first question is, what inspired you guys to go as these characters?
I decided that I kind of wanted to cosplay Edward Elric, and then he's like, up here, Alphonse. So,
and he literally just dragged me into it.
I didn't drag you, you volunteered for this.
Okay, so volunteer torture, got it.
Yeah.
Yes, involuntary torture.
Yeah.
Alright, so is this your guys' first time at Kumoricon?
No, this is my
fourth
year as well.
Fourth year as well? Alrighty, for any of my viewers who may have never attended a con, they're kind of a little about possibly going, what would you say to them?
It's a fun con, it's pretty chill, and you make a lot of friends at the con, so I recommend going or at least trying it one time.
Okay. Want to add anything?
I was gonna say, yeah, like it's. I was told it's. It might be a little bit under the comfort zone. Might go well, but you might have a fun time.
Okay. Alrighty. Now for a personal question for each character. For you, how long did it take to make all of this, or did you get it from somewhere else?
I made this completely by myself, and I had help with the strap and the.
About 8 months. All right, nice. And for you, have you been drinking up on your milk?
No.
No.
I hate milk.
Okay, just thought we would check.
No.
All right. So is it just the two of you, or is there anybody else from the show that you guys are with?
Just the two of us.
Just the two of you? Okay. All right. You hear that? That means there's openings. All right. Well, thank you, too, and enjoy the rest of Kumoricon. We've got a humanized form of Nightmare Moon because Princess Luna is best princess. So why the fuck not? Yeah. So my first question for you is how long did it take to make these wings?
Oh, these? No time at all because I bought them for $20 from someone who didn't want them.
Oh,
I managed to get these. They came Galaxy. And it was another convention.
Let's try to see if I can get the lighting on this. Push that button, see if that works. That doesn't help at all. Actually, I can see it from this angle on your right wing. So yeah, glittered.
It's pretty.
Yeah.
All right. So how about for the rest of it?
Actually, all the different pieces that you see were commissioned by different people.
Okay.
The coat was commissioned by someone who I managed to find a pattern on a coat I really loved that I thought would work perfect. I worked with the fabric, and I worked with her to create basically the perfect outfit for this.
Okay.
The wig I, of course, bought, obviously. The helmet and the chest piece were created by Tai Shell Productions, and that's a props creator.
Okay.
I made these. And these... this I had commissioned on Etsy.
Okay. Whoops. Found a wall.
Based off a couple pictures from an animation called Fall of the Crystal Empire. I took a few shots of that and I said, I want a real blade made out of this. And they said, okay. And then I painted it myself the night before Con because I was rushing.
Nice. So, how much would you say you spent total on everything?
Okay, hold up. Let's see. 60 for the wig... 130 for the helmet, 120 for the helmet, roughly, with shipping, because the chest plate was free.
Okay.
Mostly because he threw it in last minute for me, because he's very kind. The sword itself was 120, I'd say.
Okay.
And then this altogether was probably about 180 in minus fabric.
Okay, so we're looking at like $300-$400 then. Okay. So why'd you choose Nightmare Moon?
Because she's just the superior character in the show. Every time I see her, I'm like, oh my gosh, it's Nightmare Moon. It was the character that I wanted to see more of and learn more about the story. And Princess Luna's my favorite princess. I really loved the design, the helmet, the galaxy mane that I thought was really cool. So I thought that was it was just the perfect cosplay.
Okay. All right. So final question is, with this being an anime convention, you're clearly not an anime character. What would you say to the people who think that it matters one way or the other?
I would say that as long as it's something that you love and that, you know, you feel that it's a costume worth having, you should be able to go to whatever convention. I should be able to go to a comic convention and be able to be like, I'm, you know, an anime character and call, and, you know, some people will say comics aren't anime, but that I disagree. And I think that everyone should be able to come and just dress up in whatever you want.
All right. Awesome. Thank you very much. This is the ultimate showdown. So now we have Alexandrite from Steven Universe, and if you didn't know that, holy shit, you're a sad human being. So, first question is, what inspired you to choose Alexandrite of all the characters?
I'm really tall, and I really like the colors, like really kind of one of the few gems from the show that I wanted to like make a costume of or anything.
Which makes sense. Which, yeah, check out this height, people.
I've cosplayed Greg, but I don't really like want to do any of the other gems except this one. It's like some really nice coloring. Like, I mean, I might do like Garnet someday, but I mean, this took me so long since I progressed.
Alright, so about how long would you say it took?
A year and a half.
A year and a half. That's some damn dedication.
I did take a pause. I took a big pause. I was like a new name, so.
That's alright. So, I guess the last question is, for anybody who's out there who's never been to a con, but they're unsure if they want to, what would you say to them?
Come to me and I will smack them with all six of my arms. Like,
I don't think bodily harm is much of a motivator for some people.
But if they're not having fun, it's time for them to suffer.
Fair enough. Thank you very much. right, so now we got one of the most horrifying duos of all time, Freddy Krueger, or Frederick or something, and Jason Voorhees. So, what inspired you two to go as these particular characters? Thanks for the mad rush! Okay.
And this is first convention, so I'm like, oh, there's something that's
Oh, it's a newbie!
Yeah, brand new.
So how many Kumoricons have you attended?
This is my first Kumoricon, but this is my 8th year doing conventions.
Okay.
And I'm based out of Seattle, so I do that top three of Sakura.
Okay. Alright, so welcome to the family, to the both of you.
Thank you.
So, are you guys planning on keeping these going on for Halloween? Nice. That's awesome. Actually, I have an uncle whose birthday is the day before.
Nice.
So, but they're Mormons. So it doesn't really matter for him. So, no, but have you guys seen any kids that you've interacted with or anything like that? Have any children been noticing you guys?
Yeah, not spooked, but I had some people walk up like, you look like Freddy Krueger. I'm like, that's a good guess because I am.
All right, so I guess the last question is, what would you guys say to any of my viewers who maybe they've never attended a convention, they're unsure of themselves? What would you say to them to inspire them to come join the family?
Well, like, it's definitely a place to come and be around people that share your interests. If you're at a specific convention, say like a Mormon con, an anime convention, if you're interested in anime, you are guaranteed to have something in common with every single person there. And
okay.
It's just like a big happy family.
All right, cool. Well, thank you guys both very much and enjoy the rest of your con.
Thank you.
We're with Haruhi and Mikuru from The Melancholy of Haruhi, Suzumiya. Best show from 2006, give or take. So the first thing I want to ask you guys is, what inspired you to be these iconic characters?
Basically, how we act. Yeah. Let's be honest, I'm kind of very much like
common from here. So you strip her in public? That's kind of rude.
Not in public.
Oh, okay. That's a little better.
Yeah, a little better than Harley, but not much.
Not much. Okay.
Not much.
All right, so how often have you guys come to Kumoricon? Is this your first year? Or?
This is our first year.
Your first year. Now, is this your first con ever?
Yes.
What do you think of it so far?
It's actually really fun. I really like it.
Yeah, it's been, like, one of the most enjoyable times I've ever had.
And we have plans to come next year too. So.
Alright, cool. Definitely. Is there anything negative about your experience so far?
Not really, no.
No? Alright.
Oh,
somebody wants a picture! Yeah, video. I'll edit that part out, don't worry. Alright, so the last question that I have for you ladies is, for anybody who's never been to a convention of any sorts, what would you say to them?
Be prepared for anything to happen. And I would definitely plan ahead of time a lot. And also, just kind of don't stress. It's not as bad as it might seem. And be prepared to stand and wait in lines forever.
Have fun.
There you go. Have fun. That's the most important thing.
Yes, definitely.
All right. Thank you, ladies. We got the two gods from El Dorado. And if you don't know their names, holy shit, you need to read a book. All right, so my first question for you guys is, what inspired you guys to come to Kumoricon?
I personally have gone to Kumoricon for a while, I'd say like 4 or 5 years, so I naturally just come down here from Bellingham, but okay. Being in a new location is pretty awesome.
Wait, right.
Hey, drive me along.
I want a picture.
Someone wants a picture.
You're not moving.
Oh,
right. Wow, it's a pretty photographer, too.
Awesome, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Sorry.
All right.
See, I told you weren't moving.
Oh, no.
If you're on the
way, okay. I'll get another one.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome. Okay.
And right. How about you?
Thank you. That's fine.
And how about you?
No.
This is film, by the way.
Oh.
All right, so what about you? What brings you to Kumoricon?
He said, hey, we got to do this cosplay together. And I said, sounds radical. And here we are.
All right.
Being radical.
So, what sort of treasure hunts have you guys been on so far? Specifically here.
Specifically here?
Yeah.
Well, we've tried to find a few people. That's been quite a journey.
We still haven't found them.
Yeah.
How nostalgic. Oh.
It's been hours.
I can relate. Well, that's good.
We did this one great journey. It was to a magical place. What was it called? Burger or something.
Burgerado.
Burgerado, yes. It was quite tasty.
Wonderful, yes. Wonderful. Are you guys planning on continuing this costume set that you guys have going on?
Oh, is he still in the mandolin?
Yeah. That's really
good. That is true. That is true.
I mean, I could do this, but that only works for so long.
Yeah, it's not as impressive.
Air mandolin, its own.
I mean, I got sick air mandolin boots.
That's true.
All right, so I've been asking this question for everybody who I've been doing this with. If there's one thing you could say to someone who's never been to a convention, maybe they're unsure of themselves, what would you say to them?
Come down, hang out, test it out. Literally got nothing to lose. Don't even have to buy a badge.
Hey, there you go.
I'd say, you know, it might look strange to you, but to us, it's pretty normal. Everyone has their own thing that they love to obsess about. It's worth coming out, checking out the awesome costumes and the great activities and whatnot. Just do it. Do it.
All right. There you go. The gods have spoken.
Okay. Yes. And until next time.
Here with a Sakura from Naruto. I've forgotten the character's last name. So it's been a while since I've watched this show.
It's okay.
But there's a specific reason why you are being interviewed, and that is you work at one of the booths. Holy crap.
Yes, I do. I'm actually our business card. We are yesanime.com. Really awesome site, lots of stuff. I have been working with them for 5 years now, actually started at this con in 2011. So.
That's impressive.
Yeah, it was the first
time. So you were here the first of 5 years where we were in Vancouver.
Yes, actually, I didn't know that was when you guys switched, but yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
So you may have actually seen me as a male Sailor Neptune.
I see a lot of people.
Fair enough, probably. That's very true. So.
I mean, I've been here long enough. Yeah, I probably did.
Fair enough. So... what sort of range of cons do you guys go to? Is there like just a certain region?
The company itself does go to a lot. This is the smallest one we do. I personally with them do, it's about 6 going on 7 a year. Mostly the West Coast. We are talking about sending me to New York Comic Con, which I'm excited about.
Holy crap, that's big.
Yeah. Right now I do like San Diego Comic Con, Anime Expo, Fanime, this, Sakura Con, Emerald City Comic Con. So it's a lot of fun. We have such a wide variety of stuff. I'm usually just selling the shirts because I'm good at that. But I have no idea how much of this product I even have in my house. It's a little insane.
Hey, why not? You probably get discounts on this stuff, don't you?
A little bit, yeah. But a lot of it, they'll just do it as part of my pay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So what do you think of Kumoricon?
It's one of my favorites. It was the third con I ever went to, started it off working it, but I've made a lot of friends here. There's a lot of great people. It's definitely a lot smaller than the other conventions I work, but that kind of gives me a little bit more time to talk to people and hang out, which is my favorite part about cons, is making friends.
Fair enough.
That's why I work the booth. It's like, if otherwise I would just walk around with like one person all weekend, whereas working the booth I actually prefer because everyone comes to me. I don't have to be shy about talking to people.
Yeah, fair enough. So does that mean that you go to cons just as an attendee, or do you just do booths?
I have not since I started working, except I was dragged to one furry convention. That was a little bit of fun. But I kind of prefer working them. There's a few that I might go to as an attendee, but right now I'm actually also trying to get my mom starting to work a booth.
Okay.
Because she does embroidery like this here, and she made my outfit.
It's Gara.
Yeah. And I have his symbol there, you know, love.
Oh, clever.
And then I also, there's another booth here that I helped out at Rose City Comic Con down the aisle there.
Okay.
That sells my tails.
Okay, I think I know which one you're talking about.
Yeah, and then I have another friend that I helped out at Heroes and Villains Fan Fest in San Jose.
Okay.
So I just kind of, even the ones that I don't get paid to go to, I just have fun going, so I just help out friends every once in a while.
Fair enough. All right, so without revealing too much details about where you live or anything like that, do you know of local conventions that you could just go to as just an attendee?
Well, I'm from Washington. I right now work like Rose City Comic Con, or sorry, Emerald City Comic Con and Sakura Con up there. But I know there's NewCon PDX. I've thought about going to.
I went there a couple years ago. It's not bad.
Yeah, and then the first con I ever went to was actually AkiCon.
Okay.
I haven't been back to that one. That's the only one I've never gone back to after going. Just because I started working and I never really had a chance. But that'd be one I'd be interested in going back to.
Okay. Final question, possibly. So, as you've mentioned, you're kind of an advertisement. How much crap do you get for that? Like, creepers who are asking for your number, or people who are thinking you should dress a little more modestly?
I mean, even when I was 17, I had, like, a lot of older guys hitting on me. They didn't care. I was underage. It was a little bit creepy. Not as easy to get rid of guys now that I'm 21, you know, they aren't scared away by my age. But, no, I mean, there's some creepy guys, and then there's some fun ones that just like to flirt, which, you know, obviously dressing like this, I don't mind some flirting.
Okay.
But thankfully, I'm always behind a table, so nobody can do too much to me. And
that's true. That would probably really hurt to make an attempt.
I mean, I have had a couple guys try, but I just back away and they can't really do anything.
Damn.
And then that's also part, you know, we have our security guards to stop people from stealing stuff, so that helps. You know, I can always call them over if anything gets too bad.
That is true. And I would imagine, depending on the convention, there's probably their own version of security, like we have Yojimbo.
Yeah, and when I was younger, I wasn't as smart about it. I gave out my number a lot. You know, I thought people were fun, and I didn't always see at first how creepy they were. Which is part of why now I have my cosplay page, Alluring Demise, so people can message me on Facebook and I can get to know them for a little while.
Okay.
Because, like I said, I do love making friends at the cons, but it's a little bit safer for me not be passing out my number.
That totally makes sense. All right. Okay, so there is actually one more question.
Okay.
For anybody who may be watching this who's never attended a convention, but they've thought about it, they're not sure if it's for them, what would you say to them?
I would tell them the first con I ever went to, I'd only planned on being there one night. I ended up making friends, staying the night in their hotel room and going another one because it was just so awesome. I love the people, I love the atmosphere, and I feel like I can be myself. And that is the biggest reason why I just keep doing this is because I don't have to hide. I can do whatever I want, and if anyone complains, well, that's their problem because a lot of the people here will just, they'll just accept you, and it's amazing.
There we go. I'm here with the Sanderson Sisters from the greatest Halloween movie of all time, Hocus Pocus. And yes, I like it better than The Nightmare Before Christmas. Fuck off. All right, so my first question for you ladies, we can see from your badges that you're staff. What is it that you do?
So we are the maid squad. So what we do is we provide customer service. We're kind of like the face of the convention. Mm-hmm. We also do line service, make sure everyone knows where they're at. And we're kind of like a walking info booth. So if you need to have any questions, want to know where any panels are, come to either one of us, and we'll help you figure out where everything is.
All right. Do you know if other cons have something like the Maid Squad?
No. I are the only convention that has something similar.
I've heard that Sakura Con supposedly had something they were starting, but I don't know for sure if that's something they can continue to do.
Okay. All right. So y'all, you're unique. That's cool.
Yes.
So what inspired you guys to go as the Sanderson Sisters?
Halloween 2 years ago.
Okay.
And then our friend made this costume for her and tailored it, and then her and I just banter constantly anyway, so we thought it'd be fun to do all three.
Okay.
And this is the first year we've ever done it all together at the same time.
All right. So did you guys make all these costumes, or was it just this one?
I made mine.
I made mine, yeah.
How long did it take to make these?
Took mine 4 weeks.
4 weeks?
I was working full time.
I don't want to say how long mine was.
Hers wasn't nearly as long.
Okay.
It took about 4 days for that one.
It's actually not that hard. It's not complicated patterns. So.
I had to pause the movie about every 5 minutes to get the patterns right.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
It actually looks very well detailed. Seriously, look at the robe linings. Holy crap, that's amazing.
Yeah.
That's some dedication, folks. Oh my gosh, and even does the snakes in the back, too.
It's not even 100% complete yet, too. So, and then, so I made the buttons from scratch and everything as well, so if you can't buy them, chill.
Okay. Now, just out of my own personal curiosity, what's your favorite thing that your character has said or done in the movie?
My favorite line is probably, my favorite moment is when she starts crying because she gets called ugly. And then she whines about it incessantly, and then when Mary has to carry her to the window to say goodbye is probably my favorite moment.
Okay. And so what about Mary?
I would say probably the scene where she is exiting Satan's house and she takes a bite of the candy bar and thinks it's the chocolate-covered finger of a man named Lark. That is my favorite Mary moment. She's like, it's candy! Why would the master give us candy? That's the one.
And for Sarah.
During the hunt for the children, Winifred has a big monologue about what they're trying to do for the evening, and then Mary starts summarizing it, and then Sarah breaks it and says, explain what?
Awesome. All right, so final question, and I've asked this with everybody. Let's say that one of my viewers is kind of unsure if they want to go to a convention, be it anime, sci-fi, or anything else of their own interest. What would you say to encourage them to go?
Just come and see what's going on. This is only my fourth. I'm still new to the convention world. I know his face is so funny. So I just came as a staff member, and the best thing you can do is actually volunteer. That way you can kind of get the ins and outs of how the convention works, and then once you figure out how everything works, it's easier to manage your time. So I just say show up. You don't have to dress up if you don't want to. You're under no obligation, but I always encourage everyone, if you want to dress up, do it. Whether you spend 4 weeks or 4 days on a costume, or two, just show up and have a good time. Definitely bring a buddy with you, so that way, in case you get a little bored, because there's always downtime, you have someone to talk to. But yeah, just show up and you can volunteer at any convention. We're always looking for staff, specifically for the maid squad. So if anyone wants to join the maid squad for our staff, we would love it, and we will obviously work with you to help you out.
Okay, so with that being said, I already know the answer to this, but do you have to be female to be a maid squad member?
No, absolutely not. My brother was in drag a couple of years ago as one of our maids.
You can be amazing.
I think I remember that, actually.
Yeah. Yep.
We call them maid squad, but we also, if male staff members don't want to go maid outfit, we do butler status as well.
Okay.
So it's kind of open arms. We really kind of accept anyone into the group if they want to cosplay, if they want to cosplay, if they want to come in just t-shirts and pants.
I went as a butler last year.
I mean, it's entirely your preference.
All right, cool. Well, thank you very much, ladies, and enjoy your Halloween.
Thanks.
And stay out of the sunlight this time. Something else that's really great about convention life is there's a shit ton of things of all sorts of flavors. I mean, granted, the bigger the con, the more likely you're going to see stuff. But, like, right here, there's the Consulate Office of Japan in Portland. If it's a big enough city, they're going to have something like this, especially along the western coast cities. I've docked with people in the Seattle branch when I've gone up to the con up there. And I know there's one in San Francisco, Los Angeles. So, I mean, they're around. And they offer all sorts of really cool stuff, like information on tours, how they relate to anime. Like, here's a group from Lucky Star, Evangelion, Melancholy of Haruhi, Suzumiya. I mean, they're very accommodating to what this audience is trying to get them into checking out what Japan is like. And then there's also this one that's not necessarily anime related, like this. Sake 101 Pocket Guide. I love me some sake, but I'm an idiot when it comes to it. And then there's other stuff here. Something here for citizenship stuff, international school, really awesome. Talking about the Hello Kitty culture. Oh, look, a museum cafe thingy. That's actually kind of cool. Oh, my God, something about Okinawa. How awesome is that? Really informative kind of stuff, I would imagine. So, yeah, there's definitely a lot of stuff here to check out. So right now it's actually day 3. Things are getting close to being done and over with. But, these are great times. They really are. So definitely check them out. I'm sure there's something that'll tickle your fancy. Let's see what else I can get to add to this. We have a mom and her baby girl. Not really sure if they're going to anything specific, to be entirely honest. I mean, you look kind of like you're going like a wolf thing. All right. And
she's supposed to be Little Red Riding Hood, but she keeps pulling at the hood.
Ah, so makes
it's
sense.
Over there. I just have to get it back on her.
All righty. So my there we go. So my first question is, how often have you come to Kumoricon or conventions in general?
This is my third Kumoricon.
Okay.
Yeah, within the past 3 years. And then we went to Comic-Con a couple months ago.
Okay.
And that was my first Comic-Con.
All right. So for her, that would make this her second?
Yeah, her second con.
Okay. How would you rate Kumoricon as in terms of being family friendly? Because I know that's something that we bill, but that's not necessarily something that's accurate. Would you say that it is for us?
Oh, I think it's definitely family friendly and everything. I mean, she's able to just crawl around and get wherever, you know, she wants to, and everybody just kind of lets her go. Only thing you have to watch out for is obviously people who can't stand her with them.
Yeah, fair enough. So, oh, really? Yeah? So, I take it you guys are planning on coming back to Kumoricon next year?
If we're in the area, yes.
Okay. Any costume ideas for the little one yet?
I might try and do Sailor and Baby Deadpool next year for sure. We were going to do it this year, but the plans kind of fell through with it, and so we weren't able to.
Okay.
And so it will make a little more sense to do it.
That would actually be really hilarious because my 3-year-old, we're talking about having him be Deadpool next year as well. So I mean,
Dad was totally against it. He was all like, Deadpool's not a kid thing, you know. I was like, seriously? Let her, you know, dress up.
No kidding. So. And to be fair, there is a cartoon series that's technically a Spider-Man cartoon for kids, and Deadpool's appeared in it. So, oh, it's hilarious. I mean, there's one joke where they make that involves booby traps.
Uh-huh.
And you would think that with most things, he'd laugh about the word booby being said. But no, he's like, ha, 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 you said trap. So
yeah, that's definitely editing.
Oh, yeah. But it also kind of, in a way, still fit Deadpool's character.
Yes, so, definitely.
But, so, yeah. For anybody who's listening who maybe they've never gone to a con, and even more specifically, ones who are in your situation where they have children, what would you say to them about coming to con? Would you encourage them to try it?
Absolutely. Just because you have a kid doesn't mean you should, you know, stop doing what you like and cosplaying. I actually had somebody ask me Friday about,
See if we can watch her do her scooting.
About.
No, she's actually crawling.
Kind of a little bit, probably because of the shoes.
Oh, but, yeah, I guess that makes sense.
She was asking about how I manage with cosplaying and having a little one and everything. I was pretty much telling her all you have to do is just kind of incorporate your both cosplays together. Just like, you know, Wolf, Little Red Riding Hood. They go hand in hand. So,
Oh, really?
Yeah, you don't have to stop doing it just because you have a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Sure, it's more expensive, but if you can do it, so do it. Where are you going?
Oh, there we go. Oh, of course, I got the camera on. She stopped scooting. Well, thank you very much. You enjoy the rest of the con.
No problem. You too.
Thank you. So now we're with the Triforce. That was cool. Alright, so my first question is, what inspired you to do this particular costume idea?
I was playing Legend of Zelda's, I was playing Link Between Worlds. And I grew up playing the Super NES and the Game Boy version, and after playing it, I want to do like another video game cosplay. And okay. I like to do very, very simple cosplays. And I just popped into my mind, like, a Triforce kind of popped up. But I told them, like, okay, I got a good idea, but I haven't even got it started. So I kind of decided to do it on the day of the con.
So you just quickly whipped this idea up.
Yeah.
Okay, personally speaking, I think it's actually a creative idea.
So you
don't really see too many people going as the actual Triforce itself.
What's up?
You don't see a lot of people doing the actual Triforce itself. That's
I heard there was some few Triforce, but they usually have like a big triangle for each person. I kind of like to have all three at once. So
yeah, that definitely makes a lot more sense. So how many times have you come to Kumoricon?
This is my second year.
Okay.
This is my second year. Actually, I'm coming. I flew from San Francisco, California.
Okay.
So I've done some simple cosplay. Like, I've done the Brain Age cosplay. I've done the Mastering Crazy Hand cosplay. I've done it with, like, everything involving, like, I keep my cosplay, like, simple.
Okay. Yeah. So compared to something like, no offense, I'm going to get you in here real quick, a full-fledged Link. Woo!
I am. It's on your left arm, yeah. Oh, cool. Yeah, there you go.
So here, I'm gonna fuck with the view. Oh my gosh, time to hurl. Alright, so compared to him, I mean, this is a pretty cool full-fledged costume kind of thing. I mean, look at that, he's even got one of those flute things. I don't even remember what they're called. What are they called?
Ocarina.
Ocarina. God, how the fuck did I fuck that up? Wow, I'm special.
So,
we've got detailed ones like this. You've got a very simple one. For people that I've got who watch my channel, who maybe they've never gone to a con, maybe they're a little unsure of their costuming skills, would you say it doesn't matter?
I just figure out, I like to keep things simple. And plus, this is great for, you know, regardless of who we are, you know. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I know people like to say, I don't have a character that looks like I look like this and that, you know. I mean, I just try to come up with some fun ideas that we all could do, mess around with. You know, people like to want to dress up as a Death Star from Star Wars. Actually, I dressed up as the Star Wars opening.
Yes. Oh my god, that's amazing!
Yeah, I couldn't bring it here because it was raining, but this is the best. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So basically, the idea is just have fun.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Just or interact with people, yeah.
Like now, we're kind of forcing it.
Yeah.
I give them a Triforce bump.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I know.
Boom. Sweet.
Now we're like interconnected for life.
Yeah, I know, right? Like all this Zelda was like, and the Zelda's like, here you go.
And then Ganondorf.
Oh, yeah. It's like, man, I'm going to give this courage so someone could like get that, get my power back.
Just forget about him, though.
Oh, yeah.
Well, all right. Thank you very much. And also thank you for allowing us to force you into this.
Yeah.
So thank you guys. And enjoy the rest of your con.
Thanks.
We're with Yang from the amazing series Ruby. Both arms intact, apparently. Wait, was it the right one? No, I think it's the left one that she lost. Now, whatever. You got them both.
Season 3.
All right, so my first question to you is, what inspired you to go with Yang?
So I've only watched the first two.
Oh, shit. I'm sorry. Spoiler.
Big spoiler. Everyone keeps warning me about it, but I decided to go with Yang because she seemed to not need as much of a backstory as of yet in the first two, and she also didn't have as much drama, so then I didn't have to memorize all of her catchphrases and her attitude. But I also really, I just love her outfit and the way she always just runs in a battle.
That okay.
My other favorite part.
Alright. Do you have any other cosplays that you've been wearing this year, or is it just this that you've brought to Kumoricon?
I have brought two others. I was Chell from Portal 2.
Okay.
And then I was also Gaston yesterday.
Wait. Gaston isn't like Beauty and the Beast Gaston?
Yes.
Fuck yeah, that's one of my favorite villains.
So the best.
All right. Damn, I wish I would have seen that. That would have been awesome.
I didn't wear it for too long.
Oh, okay.
The rain kind of
ruin
the wig.
Yeah, that makes sense.
This one seems to be holding up a lot better. I've been in and out a lot.
Okay.
Maybe it's just the quality.
Yeah, it could be.
Yeah.
So did you make this yourself, or did you order it, or where'd you get it?
My mom and I actually worked on everything. The only things that were bought were the belt and the shoes and socks and the wig.
Okay.
And the gloves. So I built the armbands out of cardboard and hot glue and fabric. And then my mom and I worked on the top and the skirt together. And the pouch I had from another cosplay.
Look out! Here comes a Spider-Man!
So sorry for that unexpected interruption there. My phone was apparently running out of memory at the time. And so it just stopped right then and there as a result. But we basically concluded with one final question, which was something to the effect of, since she's an attractive woman cosplaying as an attractive character from a popular series, does she get a lot of crap for what she does? And by crap, I mainly mean, like, the perverts are leching on her or whatnot. And she's like, not really. Doesn't really happen a lot, at least not at Kumoricon. She's gone to other conventions where it's happened more so, but even then, still not a lot. And she actually thinks that part of it, along with people having just more respect than that, it may have something to do with her traveling with... usually there's at least a guy that she's hanging out with. In the case of this con in particular, she was with her brother. So, yeah, so it was kind of cool chatting with this gal a little bit. Found out, actually, like about 20 minutes later, that she was someone who I had made friends with at last year's con. We hung out, I wouldn't say quite a bit, but certainly more so than I did with other people at con last year. And this year we didn't hang up, hook up at all until we did this interview thing, and that was it. I literally left almost immediately after the interview was done. But, yeah, it was kind of cool to see her again, even though I didn't recognize her. But then again, she was wearing this yellow wig, and she's naturally a redhead, so it definitely threw me off a bit compared to how I'm used to seeing her.
This is the song that doesn't end. Yes, it goes on and on, my friend. Some people started singing it, not knowing what it was, and they'll continue singing it forever just because this is the song that doesn't end. Yes, it goes on and on, my friend.
That's enough, guys.
Some people started singing it, not knowing what it was, and they'll continue singing it forever just because this is the song that doesn't end.
How do I turn you off?
Yes, it goes on.
I can't believe you guys. Okay,
yes,
I've had it. That's it. That's it. What are you doing?
Some people started singing it, not knowing what it was.
Hey! No. This is the last time, right? This is it. This is it. If you guys are gonna keep that note, you go far, far away. Go, go, go! No. Keep on going. Woo! Look.
This is the song that...
Charlie, horse! No, stop. Charlie, stop. I want you to go away. Go away. And don't slam the...
door.